Hey, welcome to 12 Tone. If you've got headphones, I'd probably go grab them now. Cool? All right, check this out. I know that sounded like a bunch of random static, but did you hear the melody underneath it? Here, turn up your volume and listen to it again. If you still didn't hear it, don't worry, it's pretty faint, but if you did hear it, here's something that might blow your mind. It wasn't there. If you were to analyze the frequencies of that audio sample, all you'd see is the static. The melody existed only in your head. How is that even possible? Well, let's step back for a second and talk about sound. When something produces a sound, it travels through the air as a wave, and the frequency of that wave is what determines its pitch. A low sound like this might be only 40 hertz, meaning it hits your ear 40 times per second, whereas a higher one might be 4,000 or even more. Human hearing stretches from around 20 hertz to 20,000, although that depends on how old you are and how good your hearing is. In real life, though, we rarely encounter frequencies this pure. When you play an actual instrument, you not only produce the frequency of the specific note you're trying to play, called the fundamental, you also play a bunch of other related pitches called overtones or harmonics. These are always multiples of the fundamental. For instance, if you played this note, which has a frequency of 200 hertz, some harmonics might include 400 hertz, 600, 800, or more depending on the specific construction of the instrument you're playing. This produces an effect called the harmonic series, and our brain is really good at taking in all those different pitches and determining which one is the actual fundamental note. That system works great for naturally produced sound, which has to deal with pesky things like resonance chambers, string dynamics, and the laws of physics, but it's the 21st century and we don't have to worry about those anymore. Now we can use computers to generate perfect sine wave frequencies with absolutely no overtones, and when we do that, things get weird. If we play one sine wave by itself, there's not really much going on. It's just sort of there. It sounds rough and unpleasant because our brains are used to hearing overtones, but that's not a very surprising result. If we add in a second tone, though, something strange starts happening. Our brains recognize this as part of a harmonic series, and they start trying to identify the fundamental underneath it all. In this case, the tones we heard were 1,000 hertz and 1,200 hertz, and our ear identified them both as multiples of 200 hertz, so it filled in a ghostly version of that note. Here, listen again. It's quiet, but it's definitely there, except, again, it's actually not. This is what's called the missing fundamental effect, where your brain uses context clues to fill in a fundamental frequency it's not actually hearing, but that effect doesn't fully explain what's happening here because we can see the same thing even if our frequencies aren't actually multiples of the ghost note. For instance, here's 1100 and 1300 hertz, and we still hear that faint 200 underneath. In fact, we can hear the same effect even if the actual frequencies are moving. Here's two sliding pitches, but the difference between them will stay at exactly 200 hertz. Did you hear the note at the bottom that wasn't moving? Yeah, that note wasn't real. So instead of working out missing fundamentals, it seems that our inner ear and our brain are just calculating the differences between two frequencies, which is why these ghost notes are often referred to as difference tones. These are by far the most obvious example, but we can also combine frequencies in other ways. For instance, you can add the two together to make a sum tone, like this 900 hertz sound, produced by two tones at 400 and 500 hertz. If you couldn't hear that, though, don't worry. These are much harder to pick out than difference tones, and if I'm being honest, those aren't easy either. At this point, it's worth noting that combination tones always exist, even with normal instruments, and they can change how you hear even fairly complex sounds. In fact, they date back at least to the 18th century violinist Giuseppe Tartini, who used them to help tune his instrument. It's just that with all the different harmonics bouncing around, it can be hard to actually pick out the combination tones. You know, harder than normal. That's why I'm using sine waves to demonstrate. Which brings us back to our piece from the beginning. This is a really clever way of using combination tones that I first encountered in an article by Batuhan Bozkurt, linked in the description. It starts with a melody, which I shamelessly ripped off from Mozart. Then I randomly generated some white noise, but with a twist. I played a second line on top with a difference equal to the frequency of the melodic note. This creates a constant difference tone, even though the actual played notes keep changing, letting me bury a melody inside a bunch of static. With all that in mind, listen to it again. And remember, it's all in your head. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you want to help make these videos possible, please consider supporting 12 Tone on Patreon. You can also join our mailing list to find out about new episodes. Like, share, comment, subscribe, and keep on rocking.